The Matatu culture has gained national and international recognition, including featuring on Time magazine and Forbes, which recommended Matatu rides as one of the top 10 experiences one should not miss when visiting Nairobi, Kenya. The more glitzy and effervescent the Matatu, the more prominent it becomes to attract passengers. Tonight, we meet the man popularly known as Moha Graffix after he revolutionized the Matatu graffiti culture. In the heart of Nairobi County's industrial area, we find the artist popularly known as Moha Graffix doing what he does best. He stands out just like his art does. He says he prides himself in being different.
I don't like following trends. Everyone is wearing one watch. Why wear one? Let me put two. If I see someone else putting two watches, I'll wear three.
So now, which one do you look at the time?
Both of them, because I use both of my hands working. Because I spray with my right and left. Yeah.
What about the teeth? What inspired that look?
Okay, I had one, just one. But I saw everyone is putting one, so I decided let me just put one. Let's just put all of them.
Okay. Armed with an airbrush, he does what other artists do, but he is a different kind of artist. A self-taught graffiti artist whose canvas is metal, mostly the commercial minivans locally known as Matatus.
We have to first check the vehicle, if it's, the condition is good. Then from there, after I charge him. After I charge him, or before I charge him, we have to sit down, we decide on the theme. Because like for me, art is life. So I don't just do it for the money, I do it for my passion and my satisfaction. We have to come up with a theme. You see, like this car here, it was all about black and white. So you can even see the interior is black with the effects and white. Then we decide on a name. The theme comes with the name and the color. Because if you decide, let's say you say Manchester, you cannot do a different color, a pink. You have to look for those colors which goes with that theme. So for this one, you decided the black and white.
He calls his work moving art. Over the years, commuters have come to appreciate the more artistic vehicles. In order to ward off competition and attract passengers, Matatu owners go out of their way to ensure their minibuses are top class.
People go into pimp Matatus for the comfort, the music. Then it's like you won't go to a dirty house. So people like pimping their Matatus for more attraction, because they can, even old cars, like this is a very old Matatu, but the way we have done it, it looks new. So it's a way of attracting customers, and people in Kenya, it's like their culture. It's like something pimped is the best and is faster, more reliable.
The artwork designs vary depending on the Matatu owner's preference. Some pay homage to their favorite football clubs, while others immortalize their favorite celebrities.
The cost always depends on what you want, because like a small 14-seater like this, you just need the seats and the normal paint without a lot of graffiti. It can even go up to like 100,000. But like something like this one, you see, we have done the roof, we have put music, TVs. This one can go even up to like 400,000. You see, because the paint, we do that, like the paint with graffiti. We buy expensive paint. I use imported paints. I don't use these normal paints. And the interior, we have the seats, we have the carpet, music system. It always costs. Like the big Matatus, they can even cost up to 1 million. Because the music there is like 400,000. The seats, they put TVs on each seat. The roof, we do some crazy things on the roof, lighting and all that. So even 1 million can go just for pimping. Because even the body, we modify the body, front, rear, yeah.
The Matatu culture in Kenya has created employment for many, and Moha now works with a team of at least 10, all on his payroll.
I thank God for the 18 years, almost 20 years, I've worked hard to build my name. Now I decided, let me now, for this past 1.5 years, let me use my name to make money. I need to grow. I'm not even relying on only Matatus. I do every kind of car. I do every kind of job, from mechanical, customization, everything.
Critics have criticized some of the art on the matatus for turning Kenyan roads into a graveyard of decency, sanity, discipline and common sense. During the past few years, loud graffiti, loud music and censored videos have become the defining features of the matatu industry.
I have my principle. Even I tell my customers, there are some things I will not do. And that is what is bringing problem to these industries. There are young boys who are doing this graffiti thing and they are driven by money. It's not they are driven by passion, they are driven by money. A customer comes and tells them, I want this photo. Maybe it's a girl with a bikini. That one I will not do. It's better you leave. I have my principle. People look up to me. People take me as a role model.
Previously, the National Transport and Safety Authority announced a ban on all matatus donned in offensive graffiti, modified horns, and explosive exhaust pipes. President Uhuru Kenyatta would later lift the ban to promote entrepreneurial art and culture.
There was a time if you would come here, I'd have like 20, 30 matatus. But at the moment, because of this ban, people are scared. Because even if they say they have lifted the ban and all that, they still have some issues with matatus. So we don't have that many matatus doing them. There are only few guys who can really now want to pimp their car. It really affected us because I had many workers. I had to lay off some of them.
Moha says Kenyans unite in these matatus every day. They are a Kenyan culture and one he is proud to be part of.
In life, when you love something and you work hard for it, one day, very seriously, it will pay off. I never knew that I would have my own place like this, have employees. A lot of people depend on me.
With matatus supporting 70% of the city's 4.5 million commuters, a bigger market has been created for graffiti artists and indeed for Moha Graffix.